Praise the Lord.
Eke hallelujah.
I said, praise the Lord.
Muni eke hallelujah.
Let's close our eyes for prayer.
Eje ka di oju wa fun
ara. Almighty God, we thank you for bringing us together.
Olorun Olodumare, adupe lowo yin pe tun wa wa
pato si. We thank you for Jesus Christ, your only begotten Son.
Adupe lowo yin fun Jesu Kristi Oluwa
mo bi yin so. We thank you for the might and the power of the Holy Ghost.
Adupe fun ipa ati agbara emi mimo.
We thank you for your love that wants to bless us.
Adupe fun ife yin to fe bukun fun
wa. We pray, no Lord, you move around this crowd.
Oluwa n gbadura pe ke la ibudo yi koja.
And you will lay your hand upon everyone.
Yes, if our
every yoke you will break. Every affliction you will take away. Every sickness you will remove. And the people that have sins in their lives, you will forgive them in Jesus' name. You wonderful things in the life of the people here tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
In Ezekiel chapter 9, I'm reading from verse 4 to verse
6.
Tonight I'm talking to you on God's mark of protection. God's mark of protection. In Ezekiel chapter 9, reading from verse 4. And the Lord said unto him, go through the midst of the city, through the midst of
Jerusalem,
and set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and that cry for all the abominations that are done in the midst thereof.
Ki o si sami si iwaju awon okunrin tin kedun ti won si nkigbe.
You see what the Lord is saying there. He's sent a messenger from heaven. And he wanted that messenger to go through the city. And to set a mark of specialty upon some people. Why was he telling them to set a mark? Because judgment was coming on that city. And
enmities
were coming upon them. But he wanted to spare some people. So he said, those heavenly messengers should go around and set a mark upon the people that belong to the Lord. In verse 5, he said, and to the others, he said, in my hearing, go after him through the city and smite. Let not your eyes spare, neither have ye pity. Slay utterly old and young, both the maids and the little children and the women. But come not near any man upon whom is the mark. And begin at my sanctuary. I've revealed the great secret to you in those verses I read to you. It's a great privilege for you to belong to God. Because he specially protects the people that belong to him. And he provides specially for the people that belong to him. You have seen in the passage I read to you. On everyone that belongs to the Lord, he sets a special mark so that Satan will not be able to touch them, so that the power of darkness will not be able to afflict them, and so that the people that are working with juju power will not be able to have any power on them, so that the evil people of this world will not have any effect on them. The Bible tells us there are arrows that fly by day. Pestilences walking in dark places in the night. But the special privilege of the people that belong to God is that there is a mark upon them. And with that mark upon them, evil will pass over them. Calamity will pass over them. All the problems of life will pass over them. That's why I come to you tonight. tonight to talk to you about God's mark of protection. So that you will know how to have that protection upon you. If the protection is not there yet, as we finish, I will give you a chance to come under the banner of Christ, under the protection of Christ, at the mark of the blood of the Lamb. And from tonight, evil will see you and run away. Problems will see you and run away. Witches and wizards will see you and run away. And there will be great protection of God upon your life in Jesus' name. The three things I will not want you to forget. Number one, the men who are without divine protection. Unfortunate people. People to be pitied. People that suffer in life. People that labor in life, they don't find a place of rest. The people that the people of this world are tormenting. They run helter skelter. And wherever they run, the hand of the demons, the hand of the devil, the hand of the people of the world is catching them and touching them and tormenting them. You know the unfortunate thing about them. They do not know how to have divine protection upon them. The men who are without divine protection. The Bible talks about them in Ephesians chapter 2. Ephesians chapter 2. It talks about them in verse 12. It says that at that time. At that time, we were without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel. Aliens are foreigners. When we talk of peace, peace is foreign to them. We talk of the joy of the Lord is foreign to them. We talk of protection is foreign to them. Why? They do not know Christ. They do not know forgiveness. They do not know justification. They do not know the salvation of the Lord. It says at that time that they were without Christ, aliens and foreigners to the commonwealth of Israel. He said strangers to the covenant of promise. They do not have any kind of promise from the Lord. And it says in that verse, having no hope without God in the world, of problems, in the world of calamity, in the world of demon power, in the world of witches and wizards, in the world of sickness and oppression, they do not have a God, a God that can protect, a God that can secure them from evil. When they are sick, all they have is the hospital. They do not have the healing virtue of the Lord to pass through their body and to set them free. When there is any curse, when there is any they do not have any power beyond the power of man that can come into their family, come upon their body, come upon their wives, come upon their children, and break every yoke. The men without divine protection, they have not known how to have the divine protection of God and the mark of the Almighty upon them. Let me show you what happens to them day after day, night after night. Let me show you what happens to them, rainy season or dry season. Let me show you what happens to them during the week and on the weekend. In Psalm 78, and in verse 49, Psalm 78, 8 verse 49. You know the people I'm talking about? The people that do not have the divine mark on them, the touch of the Lord on them, the protection of the Lord on them. They are so unfortunate. They have not known how to get the power, the protection of the Lord upon their lives. Psalm 78 verse 49. He cast upon them the fierceness of his anger. wrath and indignation and trouble. Listen to this now. By sending evil angels among them. Do you know there are evil angels that are roaming about in the world? In the afternoon and in the night. And that is why calamities are coming upon some people. And there is only one thing. Only one thing. That those angels, you cannot see them. The Egyptians did not see them. All those Egyptians, in every village, in every town, in every city, in their capital, days gone by, they didn't see those evil angels. Just one night, those evil angels came and they touched every family. There was cry in every family. There was commotion in every family. You know why? Death came into their families. But there is only one mark that the angels recognize. Only one mark that those evil angels can recognize. That's a mark of the Almighty. And if you are so fortunate tonight, if you will believe the Lord tonight, if you will come to the Lord tonight, and Almighty God with his finger will put his mark upon your heart, upon your soul, upon your forehead, upon your life. Any time any of those evil personalities will see you in the day or the night, they will pass over you. They will pass over you. On one condition, that mark of the Lord is upon your life. Those Egyptians, they didn't have the mark on them. That's why they were destroyed. Many, many people today, they are suffering a lot because of the absence of that mark upon them. I go to number two. The mark of divine protection. The mark of divine protection. How I rejoice with you that you are here tonight. Because from tonight, if you will get that mark, I will tell you how to get the mark of the Lord. The mark of the Lord that will come upon you. And then it says when that mark comes upon you, in Exodus chapter 12 and in verse 13. Exodus chapter 12 verse 13. And the blood shall be unto you for a token upon the houses where ye are. And when I see the blood, everybody tell me what follows. I will pass over you. That's the mark. That's the mark. That's why one day when Jesus was coming, John the Baptist saw him and he pointed at him. He said, behold, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world. And it was not too long after that Jesus Christ, we saw him carrying the cross. He was going to the place where he will take all our sins away. And then he got to that place and they took him and they nailed him to the cross. And then the blood was gushing. The blood was gotten out. Blood from his head, blood from his hand, blood from his feet, and it is a blood. If you can see it by faith, that will drop upon you. It is the greatest mark heaven can ever put upon you. It is the greatest mark with the greatest power heaven can put upon you. It is the greatest mark with the greatest protection that the angels recognize. It is the greatest mark with the greatest protection that Satan and demons can never overcome. It is the greatest mark that can come upon your life, and witches lose their power, wizards lose their power. When I see the blood, I will pass over you. All your talisman means nothing to the devil. The charcoal that you bring together, and the lizard that you burn together, and the parts of animals you burn together, and the bark of a tree you burn together, and all those leaves you burn together, and the things you write on that paper, and you wrap it up, and then you put it on your waist, you put it on your neck, you put it in your hand, you put it on your arm. It's nothing to the devil. There is only one mark. Only one mark. And it comes from heaven. born. And it is a mark of the blood of Jesus. And Almighty God said, all those evil angels that are in the world, all those demons that are in the world, all the witches and wizards in the world, all the powers of darkness in the world, the pestilence in the night, the arrows in the day, the affliction that comes upon people, all the calamities, and all the yokes, and all the curse. He says, I'm looking for just one mark. I'm looking for just one mark. When I see the blood, I will pass over you. Anybody can pretend. I go to church. That doesn't interest the devil. I go to church. That doesn't stop the witches and the wizards. I read the Bible. I read the Psalms. I wear this. I don't wear that. All that does not matter to the devil. There's only one thing. That when the devil sees that thing, when the evil angels see that thing, the mark of the blood of the Lamb. Tonight, when you believe the Lord, you turn away from your sin. You run to Jesus Christ. You say, yes, I believe. Yes, I believe that Jesus died for me. I believe he died to take my sins away. I believe he shed his blood for me. And you come to Calvary. And you come under his cross. And then he's over there. Because Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. As powerful as the blood was at that time, that blood is still powerful today. As fresh as the blood was at that time, that blood is still very fresh today. You come under Calvary. You come under Christ. And as you bow the knee and bend your head and believe the Lord, that the blood of Jesus will come upon you. If there is any devil there, any demon there, any sickness there, any oppression there, immediately the blood of the Lamb comes upon your life. Sin will vanish away. Sickness will vanish away. Satanic power will vanish away. Affliction will vanish away. If you are blind, you will see. If you are lame, you rise up and walk. If you are deaf and dumb, your ears will open. If you have mental problems, what's the mark of the blood of the Lamb comes upon your life? Finished. I said finished. All your calamities, all the yoke, all the evil in your life until this time, everything will be finished in Jesus' name. Remember, it says, when I see the blood, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. That's why I'm inviting you tonight. That you will come to Jesus Christ. You will turn away from your sin. You will abandon the works of darkness. You will say, yes, I belong to Jesus. I come under the protection, under the mark of the blood of the Lamb. Revelation chapter 12. Revelation chapter 12. And it is there in verse 11. It says, and they overcame him. Who is that talking about? They overcame the dragon. Who is that talking about? They overcame the old serpent. Who is that talking about? They overcame the devil, Satan, the accuser of the brethren. Who is that talking about? It's talking about the originator of evil and all the problems of your life. When you have the mark of the Lamb, it says the blood, by the blood of the Lamb, they overcame him.
They overcame him
by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. What's the word of their testimony? Jesus died for me. I believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. I become a disciple of Christ. I become a follower of Jesus Christ. I will never leave Christ. I will never forsake Christ. Christ is mine. I belong to him. When you have that testimony, that you have given yourself to the Lord, you overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. And they love not their lives unto the dead. What does that mean? It means they love Jesus so much. They don't fear the people that threaten them. They know that the power of Christ will break every other power. Therefore, they don't fear all those powers that are powerless. They belong to the Lord. Tonight, as you take that decision, you have divine protection upon you. I said you have divine protection upon you. That leads me to point number 3. This is beautiful. And there is no way I can exhaust everything I want to say in point 3. When you come to the Lord,
nígbà tó bá tolú
wa. You have divine protection.
Tó ní ààbò látọ̀run wá.
I'm going to talk now point number three.
Kókó kẹta.
The measure of divine protection.
Ààbò látọ̀run wá.
The measure.
Òṣùwọ̀n rẹ̀.
Of divine protection.
Òṣùwọ̀n ààbò látòkè wá bó ti gbòòrò tó.
It's only when you come to the Lord you will understand.
Ìròyìn òtáfojúbà tó bá tó Kristi wọn ni yóò tó yí ọ agbára náà.
The protection.
Ààbò náà.
The provision.
Ìpèsè náà.
The pardon.
Ìdáríjì náà.
The purity.
Ìwà funfun náà.
The entrance into heaven.
Àti ọ̀nà ọ̀nà bá wọlé sí
ọ̀run rere. The privilege that the Lord will give you.
Just
because the mark of the blood of the Lamb is upon you.
Nítorí pé àmì ẹ̀jẹ̀ ọ̀dọ̀ àgùntàn náà ń bẹ lára rẹ.
In Revelation chapter 7.
Nínú ìfihàn orí keje.
Revelation chapter 7.
Ìfihàn orí keje.
I'm reading there from verse 2.
Jẹ́ kí n kà
láti ẹsẹ̀ kejì. And I saw another angel ascending from the east.
Mo sì rí angẹ́lì mìíràn tí ó ń ti ìyà ìlà òrùn
gòkè wá. Having the seal of the living God.
Tí ó ń ti èdìdí ọlọ́run
àlàyé lọ́wọ́. And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels.
Ó sì kígbe ní ohun rárá sí
àwọn angẹ́lì mẹ́rin náà. To whom it was given to the earth and the sea.
Tí a fi fún láti pa ayé àti òkú rárá.
Say wípé. Hurt not the earth.
Ẹ má ṣe pa ayé.
Neither the sea.
Tàbí òkun.
Nor the trees.
Tàbí igi lára.
Till we have sealed the servants of our God in their forehead.
Títí àwa ó fi fi èdìdí sàmì sí àwọn ìránṣẹ́ Ọlọ́run wa ní iwájú wọn.
That is when you have that mark of the Lord upon you.
Èyí ni pé nígbà tó bá ní àmì Olúwa yìí lára rẹ.
In your community.
Ní àwùjọ ibi tó ń gbé.
If the devil wants to do anything.
Bí èsì bá fẹ́ dà nǹkan rú nílẹ̀.
The Lord Almighty God will say stop.
Ọlọ́run Olódùmarè yóò pé dáwọ́ dúró níbẹ̀.
Let me secure my own.
Jẹ́ ń dáàbò
bá wọn tèmi mọ́. Let me protect my own.
Jẹ́ ń pa wọn tèmi mọ́ná.
It's after you are protected.
Lẹ́yìn tí a bá ti
dáàbò bọ̀. After you are sealed.
Tá a ti fèdìdí
yọ. And then the mark of the Lord is ensured upon your life.
Tí àmì Olúwa dájú lára rẹ náà.
And nothing can touch you.
Tí kò sí èmi mi kan tó lè mi
rọ. Then the devil can touch the other people that do not have the mark of the blood of Christ.
Nígbà àwọn tó kù dára tó bá wù wọ́n tí wọ́n jẹ́ àmì ẹ̀jẹ̀ Jésù lára.
Because of you.
O jẹ́ mọ̀ nítorí
ìdílé will break the jawbone of the enemy in Jesus' name.
Olúwa yóò kan egungun parí ẹ̀rẹ̀kẹ́ ọ̀tá nítorí rẹ lórúkọ Jésù.
Come back to come to the Old Testament.
Padà wá sí
Lọ́jẹ̀ Mọ́lá. First Chronicles.
Chronicle kìíní ni mò ń wò.
In First Chronicles.
Nínú Chronicle kìíní.
Reading from chapter 16.
Orí kẹrìndínlẹ́ni ogún.
First Chronicles chapter 16.
Chronicle kìíní orí kẹrìndínlẹ́ni
ogún. Look at verse 20.
Wọ ẹsẹ̀ ogún níbẹ̀.
And when they went from nation to nation.
Wọ́n sì ń lọ láti orílẹ̀-èdè
bí orílẹ̀-èdè. And from one kingdom to another people.
Àti láti ìjọba kan dé ọ̀dọ̀ ènìyàn mìíràn.
He suffered no man to do them wrong.
Òun kò jẹ́ kí ẹnikẹ́ni kó ṣe wọ́n ní ìwọ̀sí.
When the mark of the Lord comes upon you.
Nígbà tí àmì Olúwa bá wá sórí rẹ.
He will not allow any witch to do you wrong.
Kò ní jẹ́ kí àjẹ́ kankan
sí ọ́ ní ìwọ̀sí. Any wizard to do you wrong.
Kò ní jẹ́ kí ọjọ́ kankan sí ọ́ ní ìwọ̀sí. Kò ní jẹ́ kí agbára
kankan sí ọ́ ní ìwọ̀sí.
Òun kò jẹ́ kí ẹnikẹ́ni kó ṣe wọ́n ní
ìwọ̀sí. Kings for their sake.
Ní tòótọ́, ó bá àwọn ọba wí nítorí wọn.
Saying, touch not my anointed.
Wípé ẹ má ṣe fọwọ́ kẹ́ni
àmì òróró mi. And do my prophets no harm.
Ẹ má sì ṣe àwọn wòlíì mi ní ibi.
It's not only talking about preachers, it's talking about the people that have the anointing of God, that have the mark of the blood of the Lamb upon them.
Àwọn oníwàásù nìkan kọ́ ló ń bá wí, ó ń bá gbogbo àwọn ọmọ Ọlọ́run tó ní àmì
òróró mi. That's why tonight I'm inviting you.
Ibi tí mo fi ń pè ọ́
lálẹ́ yìí. That you come under the mark of the blood of the Lamb.
Gbogbo wá sábẹ́
àgbẹ̀ ẹ̀jẹ̀
Jésù. Ààbò ẹ̀jẹ̀ ọ̀dọ́ àgùntàn náà.
Evil cannot touch you again.
Ìwọ̀n búburú ò ní lè
fọwọ́kàn mọ́. The money pass cannot touch you again.
Agbára ẹ̀mí èṣù ò lè fọwọ́kàn mọ́.
Your experience will be what I read to you in Psalm 91.
Ìrírí tó ní ni wọ́n kà sí tí
gbọ́dọ̀ lórí Dáfídì. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High.
Ìkọkànléláàdọ́rin ẹni tójó kò ní ibi
ìkọ̀kọ̀
bá òkú.
You believe that the Lord Jesus Christ, the blood of Jesus, washes away your sin, cleanses you from all iniquity, and that mark is on your heart, that mark is on your soul, that mark is on your body. Ordinarily cannot see, but Almighty God has put the mark upon you, and then all the people that see you, if they want to do anything against you, they know that you are in the secret place of the Most High. You will dwell and abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will see of the Lord. He is my refuge. He is my fortress. He is my God. In Him I will trust. Surely, He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. Look at it now. He shall cover thee with his feathers as the hen will cover the chicks. From the eagle, the eagle will not be able to touch you again. Under his wings shall thou trust. His true shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night. You will sleep well. You have rest of mind. You have peace in your soul. Because the protection of the Lord is upon you. He says, thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, of the arrow that flies by day,
or
nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness,
or
for destruction that wasteth at noonday. A thousand shall fall by thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand. It shall not come near you. I said it shall not come near you. As if you come to Christ tonight,
may
the mark of the blood of the Lamb be upon you tonight. Only with thine eyes thou shalt behold and see the reward of the wicked, the cause that has made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee. There shall no evil befall thee. There shall no evil befall thee. Neither shall any plague, any sickness, any disease, any deformity, any mental problem, neither shall any plague come near thy dwelling. Tonight it will be fulfilled in your life. He will forgive your sin. He will take away your sickness. He will provide for your family. Any problem there, the Lord will take everything away. Only on one condition, that you come to the Lord, and the mark of the blood of the Lamb is applied on you. How many of you want that divine protection? How many of you want that divine protection? Can you rise up on your feet? You are a candidate for blessing. You are a candidate for deliverance. You are a candidate for healing. You are a candidate for the salvation of the Lord. You are saying, yes, I want it. I want the blessing of the Lord. Yes, I want it. That means you repent of your sin. That means you call on the name of the Lord. You say, now I belong to the Lord. He will do it. He will do it. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. And say, I come to Christ. I come to Christ. I come to Christ. I come to Christ. He died for me. He shed his blood for me. So that all my sins will be cleansed away. Confess your sins to the Lord. And repent of those sins. And the Lord will forgive you.
And then.
He will put the mark of the blood of Jesus upon you. He will put the mark of the blood upon you. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you. When I see the blood, I will pass over you. It is a mark of God's protection. It is a mark of divine protection. It is a mark of protection that will not allow all those evil powers to touch you again. Give yourself to Jesus. Surrender yourself to Jesus. Turn away from your sin. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. And you will be saved. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I told you tonight, the only sin the devil will see and then pass you over. The demons will see and not be able to touch you. The wicked people of the world will see and not be able to touch you.
There's
a mark of the blood of Jesus. And that's when you repent of your sin. And you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. And you hand over your life unto Jesus. And then he puts the divine mark upon you.
Heads
bowed and eyes closed. If you want that mark of the Lord, the divine mark of protection, if you want it upon you tonight, and you want to be secured in the kingdom of God, wherever you are, you will raise up your hand.
You're
telling the devil, I don't belong to you anymore. If you have been born again, if already you have done this before, don't do it again now. It's all right to put it. If you want the mark of the blood upon your life, you want it to protect you. You want to belong to the Lord completely. And Almighty God will say in heaven, He will command the demons and the devils. The mark of the blood of Jesus is on that man, that woman, that boy, that girl. You Satan, I command you, don't go near him. If you want that protection, you raise up your hand.
Ami ejo mo mi Jesu Kristi nbe laro okunrin yen obirin yen omode yen odokunrin odobirin yen
Keep up your hand. You want the mark of the blood of the Lamb. And you want all your sins to be forgiven. You want to be called a child of God. And Jesus is coming to you now. He said, I died for you. I died for you. So that all your sins can be taken away. Almighty God is saying, when I see the blood, when I see the blood, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. Not the blood of animals, the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. Keep up your hands. I'm praying with you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for all these that are raising up their hands. Almighty God, according to your promise, let the mark of the blood of Jesus come upon them in Jesus' name. All the sins they have committed since they were born until this very moment, according to your love, according to your mercy, forgive them in Jesus' name. Cleanse their sins. Wash their sins away. Give them salvation, O Lord, in Jesus' name. Put that mark upon them now. In their heart. In their soul. On their body. That now, when judgment comes, judgment will pass over them because of the mark on them. I thank you because I know you have answered. Thank you, Jesus, because I know you have come to their heart. Thank you, Lord, the mark is upon them now. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I said, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is time for your miracle now. It is time for your healing now. It is time for your deliverance now. The Lord is coming your way. The power of God is coming your way. We're going to pray now. Whatever problem, whatever infirmity, whatever deformity you have, the mighty power and hand of God is going to touch you. Immediately after the prayer, are you here? And the final amen of the people of God. You open your eyes. If you were blind before, you'll see the miracle upon you. If you were lame before, you will rise up. The power of God will hold you up. If there is any problem, any pain, any sickness, disease anywhere, immediately we mention the name of Jesus. All those things will vanish away. And you'll check, you will see the mighty power of God there. If you have been praying tonight, the Lord will touch the husband and the wife. You will carry your baby next year. You raise up your hand if you need this kind of miracle prayer. And then where you have the sickness, the problem, you lay the other hand. The time has come for you to be healed and delivered. Let us pray. Almighty God, we come before you. We thank you because of the mark of your protection upon us. You have said, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. And all these people have believed on the Lord Jesus Christ. The mark of the blood of Jesus is upon them. He was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for iniquity. The chastisement of our peace has been upon him. With his stripes, everyone is healed tonight. Touch them, heal them in Jesus' name. I bring all the congregation before you tonight. Every man, every woman, every boy, every girl. I pray that your healing virtue will come upon them in Jesus' name. Satan, I break your power over them in Jesus' name. All those powers, workers, works of darkness, I destroy you right now. Be removed in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those that have any swelling on them. Swelling of goiter. Swelling of hunchback, swelling of tumor, swelling of elephantiasis, swelling of hernia. I command that swelling come out in Jesus' name. All the sicknesses within their body, the tuberculosis, the diabetes, the kidney problem, I command you sickness with pain and disease, come out in Jesus' name. All the asthma that is worrying them, every kind of thing that is bringing pain in their body, the high blood pressure upon them, the problem in the head that they have, all those afflictions, all those plagues and diseases, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. The ulcer and the cancer, I command you right now, come out in Jesus' name. The pan and the one that is urinating blood, I pray the hand of the Lord will touch you right now. Be healed in Jesus' name. The leprosy and the skin disease, I command you right now, be removed from their body in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, all those people that are so sick and weak, that they cannot rise up on their own, I pray that your mighty hand will touch them. The sickness and the weakness and the pain, remove it from them in Jesus' name. I pray that the power, the strength of the Lord will enter into their body right now. That they will rise and walk in Jesus' name. The HIV and the AIDS, I command you, be removed and cleansed away from their body in Jesus' name. The people that have different objects walking about in their body, feels like ants moving about in their body, the one that felt that a lizard entered into her, I command all those powers of darkness, come out in Jesus' name. The one that has epilepsy, and the one that has a madness and insanity, I command that spirit of madness and that spirit of epilepsy and convulsion, come out in Jesus' name. All the people that have any curse, any yoke upon them, I break that yoke. I remove that curse. You are set free. You are delivered in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo awon to ti fori gbegun ninu ile won tabi ti ota ti gbere ti won gbe labi ajaga gbogbo egun ati ajaga na mo ja kuro e gba omi ninu ile oruko Jesu.
All those that are looking for children, I pray the Lord will touch you, the husband will touch you, the wife, receive your miracle baby in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo eyin ta ti se gbeyawo ta n woju Oluwa fun omo Oluwa mo gbadura pe ke fi owo kan oko Oluwa ke fi owo kan aya e gba awon omose iyanu yin bayi ni oruko Jesu.
All those blind eyes there, anywhere you are now, I command the mighty power of God to touch those blind eyes. Blind eyes, I command you, be opened in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo awon oju to ti fa ni yi mo gbadura pe ki agbara lo Olodumare ko fowo ka oju na iwo oju to fa.
Lame and paralyzed people, or one leg shorter than the other, or the hand is withered and you cannot walk on your own, or your spinal cord is damaged, I pray that the mighty power of God will flow through your body right now. Rise up and walk in Jesus' name.
Tero lapa kan tabi ro lese kan tese mejeji o se rin eyin tegun eyin yin ti kan eyin ti bi kan gbe ninu ara yin tese kan kuru si ekeji bayi mo gbadura ki agbara Olodumare ko wonu agbo ara yin e didi e bere si rin ni oruko Jesu.
All those who are deaf and dumb, I pray that the Lord will recreate your eardrum, will loosen your vocal cords, and you'll begin to hear, you'll begin to speak out clearly in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo eyin te je aditi te tun ya odi mo gbadura pe ki agbara isede Olorun ko wonu agbo ara yin ko tun eti yin da ko tun ahan yin se ki okun na ja
Heavenly Father has not planted every plague and every disease, every infirmity and every insanity, every yoke and every problem, every affliction, every attack coming from the devil, I remove you right now. You have no right to be there. I command you, when we hear the amen of the people of God, you vanish away. You have no right to be there. Come out in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, confirm the miracle on their body. Confirm the miracle in their life. Confirm it right now. Thank you, Lord, because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.